Brighton is an old, I used to live here until very recently, so it's great coming back. And of course, I have a lovely relationship with Showmasters, so it's always fun to see lots of familiar faces and lots of new faces here also. It's a different crowd. It's the familiar, but then there's lots of people that have just come in to visit because they happen to be in Brighton and they see the signs. And that's always a treat because you can tell from the looks on their faces they've never been to a Comic-Con before. Usually they want to know from Superman, how do you fly? Or what was Christopher Reeve really like to work with? So I've, for instance, this afternoon I've got a question and answer coming up, and I just so very much hope that we'll have some original questions because I'm a bit sick of the usual run of the mill. But it's always about Superman. That's what people really want to know about. And also, because we've got a few Doctor Who people here, I've only done the audios of Doctor Who, and I've done some video games. So I've got a little bit of Doctor Who credit, but not a lot. But there's lots of Doctor Who fans. So that's another thing. Lots of fans there asking questions about what it's like to do audio, etc., etc. But this is good. This is a fun one. And we've got the sea outside and the sun's coming out. So what more could you want?
Why do you think of all the different versions and iterations of this hero and this story that we've seen, the one that you were involved in seems to be hailed as the most beloved and the most cherished, I guess?
First and foremost, I think Christopher Reeve was the ultimate Superman. There's no getting away from that. I also think that if you like the simplicity of our original Supermans, well, it wasn't the original, obviously, but our Supermans back from the 70s, with Christopher, the humour in it, the gentle humour and the gentleness of it. A lot of the others have got quite dark, quite scary, and you can't really say that our Superman's too scary. I mean, yes, I do go around blowing helicopters out the sky and knocking down buildings and throwing little kids over my shoulders. But the fact of it is that the people still want more. And as villains, a lot of us have... I've been asked a lot about what it's like to be compared with your latest reincarnation, if you like, of Ursa. In the last Superman film, and there really isn't a comparison, I thought the costumes were fantastic, the whole look was fantastic, but our supermen, our supervillains, we were just in black organza. We have no weapons, no guns, no nothing, just our superpowers. And I think that wins out. We don't need any extra stuff. We just needed ourselves and the piercing eyes and the X-ray vision and the super breath. And, we have powers beyond reason. What more do you want? Obviously, we had wires and a small harness. But not like, unlike Peter Pan, who had a full body harness that went on, because of my costume, which a lot of your people will remember, have slits and cuts, and they expose quite a bit. And so consequently, I could only wear a very slight harness, because otherwise it would have shown. So the support for my back was, the support for me was literally my back, my own body. There was no harness doing it. Very uncomfortable. And when I wasn't on a wire, we were on a pole arm, which was a long arm coming out of the blue backing behind us, blue screen. I then lay in a body mold, and you were the camera, and my body blocked the arm that came out of the back. So it looked as if I was just lying there. It was all very cleverly positioned. But I'm afraid there was no magic, there's no magic secret to this. We can't fly, and I would hasten to add, for sometimes people seem to think that if they jump off a windowsill, especially little kids, perhaps they can fly. No, you can't. It was all done in the studio, special effects, and wasn't it brilliant? Do you know, I have to tell you, the first time I went to see the first screening of Superman 1, and we all knew how we had done it, and we'd spent many, many months doing it, but to see Superman actually fly for the first time and realize that he really could fly. We couldn't see any wires, we couldn't see anything. How brilliant is that? How brilliant. And I've always said, to me, he was more like Clark Kent than Superman. He was a decent, kind, honorable bloke that would do anything for you. He was very much like Clark Kent. And obviously he had superpowers because we know how he managed his disability and went on. Was phenomenal. But he was a decent man. And I think that shows throughout all his work. He's an honourable, decent bloke. What more can I say? Arnold, still to this day, is an absolute dislike. Oh my goodness me, delight. I apologise for that. It's an absolute delight. I run into him now and then. He always gives me a big hug. Always wants to check that I'm in shape. Will let me know if he thinks that parts of my body need a bit of firming up. So he's very onto that. I mean, he's very onto making sure you're in the best shape, which is not a bad thing. Having said that, I knew him before he got married. We were filming before he got married. And I can honestly say in our weeks in Mexico, during the week when his fiance was not there, we all enjoyed a pretty good time. We all had a lot of fun. And on the weekend, his fiance, Marie Shriver, would come into town and he would behave himself and be a decent, honourable chap. But was quite different. So I got the best of both worlds, and he's quite naughty. And I'll tell you what I love about him is he's had the same group of friends who have worked with him and around him, particularly from the bodybuilding world, and those friends have remained in his life, and he's kept this small sort of coterie of people around him. And then he became the governor, and we all... stop telling stories, because you don't tell stories about the governor of California, do you? But now he's not the governor, so come back in a couple of years and maybe I'll tell you some of the real stories about Arnold. I really can't stress enough what impact it has on me that people are bothered to come out, that want to stop and say hello. You know, I know I'm not working a lot, like a lot of actresses, you know, of my age, work starts to slow down. And it's brilliant that the fans don't come and say, whatever happened to you? They just want to talk about stuff you've done, tell you stories, anecdotes of where they were the first time they saw Superman. Or I've had all sorts of different stories this morning about all the different work I've done. They are very much appreciated. And it's not, without giving away too much, it's not the easiest of times for me at the moment, because my mom is getting on and I'm taking care of her. And it's my pleasure to do so. But she's going to be 95 soon. And so it's a lot of taking care of mum. So to come away from that and to come to one of these events where it's all about me and everybody being lovely and kind, it just restores my faith and gives me a bit of a boost. And so I can go back to mum next week and give her a bit more love and attention. So thank you to all the fans. It's much appreciated.